Okay, good morning. Welcome to my talk, A State of Compile-Time Regular Expressions. My name is Hana Dusíková, and I'm National Party Chair of Czech Republic of WG21, and I'm Senior Researcher in AVAST, and I can hear myself. And I'm organizer of AVAST Prague C++ Meetup. Okay, regular expressions. How many of you, at least once in their career, use regular expression? Okay, how many of you used standard regular expression in C++? Less people? Okay. Almost every language supports regular expression in their library. Okay, we have benchmark of regular expression, Perl egrep. PHP, Python, JavaScript Core, Node.js, Java, Rust on the left, Java on the right, C++ on the right. Okay. CTRE, this is the library I'm talking about, is on the left for this regular expression. Different regular expression is a little bit different, and our Rust CTRE is switched. Okay. Thanks to my friends, which provide me a benchmark for this. And this is an example of standard regular expression in C++. We have function extract date, which takes string view and returns optional with date. There is a pattern which extracts year, month, day. And if it's not a date, it returns null opt. Okay, problems. Standard regular expression cannot be no except because it can throw error if the pattern is wrong. String view is not supported by current standard regular expression, so you need to change with pair of iterators. Then you need to change smatch to match result of string view iterators. Okay, I think we are ready, done. Not really. We don't need to build the pattern every time, so it's going to be static. I'm done with this. And it compiles 1.3 seconds. So, how many of you are going to use static checks in future? None. Great. Okay, the compile time regular expression library. Same example with CTRE. Extract date, string view, optional, pattern, but as a template argument, and extracting year, month, day with structured bindings. And if it's not match, it returns null opt. It's no accept, and it's return date. Okay, another example. If you provide wrong regular expression into the library, like missing closing parents, it gives you compile time error. Okay. It doesn't support Unicode. You give it a Unicode string, and you check if a string contains only emoji, and you can do it in constexpr with static assert. Or no. It's not fully merged yet. It's in special branch, and but you can play with it. Basic Unicode support is part of the master branch, but if you want Unicode tables, which are provided by current in Jabo, is he here? I cannot see him. Okay. Also, the library supports DFA matching and searching. Function fast search, fast match, which converts the regular expression into DFA machine, and it's much quicker than default backtracking engine. And I'm going to talk about the DFA machine in the library in this talk. Okay, features of the library. It's PCRE2 compatible dialect with basic Unicode support, it's constexpr. It doesn't support runtime patterns, and it do the compile time construction. So everything is done during compilation. But it supports context pair and runtime matching. And gives you very quick regular expression matching and searching, obviously. Structure binding support and DFA without captures, because you cannot have captures with DFA. And generates a really nice assembly. I'm going to show you later. Details are, it's small header-only library, supports all major compilers, Clang, GCC, MSVC, thanks to support of developers of the compilers, especially from Microsoft. It's open source, Apache 2 license, and it's available on GitHub. Okay, regular expressions. Regular expression formally is empty set, which doesn't accept anything, empty string, so regular expression accepting only empty string, or literal char, or one char, A, B, C. Or it's concatenation of two regular expressions, alternation of two regular expressions, and repetition of regular expression zero or multiple times. Okay, there are some non-formal syntax constructs, like optional regular expression, which is empty string or regular expression. Plus repetition is just regular expression concatenated with regular expression star. Back references. No, back references are not regular expressions. Don't use them. They are slow. Okay. And you can convert almost every regular expression into formal form. Okay, there is an example of the conversion. Okay. The regular expression itself is AST. So you can see the alternation has highest priority. It's one regular expression or second. It's the first is concatenation of something and something. It's just a tree. And if you want to build the tree, especially in compile time, you need to somehow generate it. You can use tree-like data structure, like allocation, but currently on in C++ 20, and it's implemented only in EDG, so I didn't play with it. So I went with type-based expressions. It's expression templates like boost expressive or tuple-like empty types. I went with tuple-like empty types. Okay. You can build the AST with only these types. You have structure, empty struct epsilon, you have struct expressing char, you have struct expressing concatenation, alternation, repetition, and so on. For example, we have CT optional RE, and it's array concatenation, optional, and so on. For example, this regular expression is concatenation of A, B, C, or it's just alternation of A or B. Okay, we need to convert the pattern into AST during compilation. How do you do it? I decide to use a generic L11 parser to do it. And I provide the PCRE compatible grammar into the parser, and the output is obviously the AST as the type. Okay, how many of you played with L11 parser in their career? Awesome. So, L11 parser start is a machine which starts with a start symbol on stack. That is a stack, and at the beginning, that is a special start symbol. On every step, the machine pops one symbol from the stack, checks current output, and based on the pair of the input and symbol, decide if it's going to push string of symbols on the stack, pop char on the input from the input, or reject. Or it's repeating the algorithm until the stack is empty and input is empty, and then it's accepting. Otherwise, it's rejecting. Okay, there is a table representing a simple regular expression grammar. On the top, you can see symbols from the input. On the left, you can see symbols on the stack. if we decide to pop something, for example, if we are at start of the parsing, symbol S, and open braces, open curly parent, I push something on stack, or I push empty string, which means I just move to next symbol. Or I pop input, which means I'm moving to next symbol. Or I'm rejecting, at the end I'm accepting. Okay, that is a demo for parser. At the end, there is a start symbol, and I'm going to push other, which is special terminal for any other symbol than is defined. A or B, and at the end, it accepts because it's valid regular expression. If I show this, I match the first parenthesis and match one closing, and there is a missing parenthesis, so it's rejecting. Okay. How do we represent these symbols for the parser in L1 grammar in compile time? As a type. It's template-based metaprogramming, so it's type. And special type is alias start symbol for some symbol S in this case. Then we need to implement the grammar, the table. We need to dispatch based on the input and char what action will go next. In this case, I use overloading resolution. So if a function f takes symbol and terminal, it's pushing list of items on stack. If it's a function which takes term and term, it's same symbol on stack and input, I'm just popping input, which is special symbol for popping input. If it's something else, dot, 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 it's sync, which is lowest priority in overloading, it's just reject. And if it's empty stack and epsilon, I'm accepting. Okay, the grammar, I need to provide the grammar to parser somehow, because it's just a bunch of types. So I cannot namespace it, but I can wrap it into structure. So I can provide the structure to as a template argument to parser later. Okay. The parser is used like this. We have parser, first argument is grammar, second argument is string. I'm parsing, and there is a variable correct, which says if it's true or false, if it's parser accepting or rejecting the input. It looks like this. First argument is grammar, and I'm looking into grammar for the function f, which is the table, and based on that, I'm deciding what will be my next move. Okay, the string is implemented with Jeff's paper and CNTTP feature of C++ 20. More about it in his talk later, so I'm not going into it. It's going to be today. Yes. Yeah. Today, Jeff's talk. You should go. Okay, this tag for the parsing is implemented as another type. It's a template, struct list, which takes type name types as the arguments. Function push is just empty function, which takes the stack and string of symbols and returns new stack. It's functional programming, so you are not modifying the stack, you are creating new one. If I'm popping something, I just look on the first symbol T on the stack, and I return stack without it. If I'm looking on the top of the stack, I look on the first symbol and I return it. And if I'm looking on empty stack, I'm returning special symbol empty. Popping, returning new stack. I have special function which look on the on the top. Yeah. That is a typo. Sorry. Okay. How does it fit together? I have parser, PCRE, and grammar. The parser looks like this: takes the grammar string and call function parse with the start symbol on stack. stack is the argument. There is also function getChar, which look on the current position, and based on that return terminal with the char or epsilon. Because it's based on the template argument, I can return different types. Parse function takes the stack, current position, looks on the top of the stack, on current char, and called function f from the grammar to decide what will be next move. It's just decal type because the function doesn't need any body, so it's just deciding with template overloads, nothing else. Oh, function overloads. I call function move with new stack and current move, and there is another overloading resolution, which takes stack and list of symbol I'm going to push, and just call function push on the stack and call function parse again recursively. Same thing for popping input. It just moves to next position of the input. And if action is reject, I'm returning false. If accept, I'm returning true. So we did parsing, we get true or false. But we need more, we need type from it. So we need to do it. So there is a L1 table, and it's augmented with special semantic actions, these. And every time I hit them during parsing, I do something with them and modify output. I need to tag them with overloading. There is a tag called action, which is used by inheritance. So I can decide if it's ordinary action or ordinary terminal, non-terminal, or action. The parser look similar, but output is suddenly has two arguments, subject and start symbol. This is start subject. Subject is some object or type I'm modifying. Parse function takes two arguments now, stack and subject. It looks on the top of the stack, and if the symbol is semantic action, it looks on the previous term on the input, and called function modify. Modify function takes the symbol, which is some action like concatenation, alternation, previous symbol, and current subject, and return new subject. It's still function programming. And then, with new subject, it called parse function again recursively. Old approach is same. You look on char, you look on a table, and decide what to do next. Okay. Move functions are same, but there is third argument. Subject, which is just going through the call without any modification. For popping, pushing, popping, and reject and accept returning pair of boolean and the subject. And at the end, we have correct variable called correct, which tells us if the parsing is correct or not, and output type. So you provide to your parser your pattern, and at the end, you have type generated from it. Okay. And the AST looks like this. Maybe see. In this example, you can see that I'm having pattern AB, and the colorful squares at the bottom are semantic action. And if you can see that they are in order AB concatenation. They are in postfix notation. So you can join them, AB, and have concatenation. If you do more, ABC, you have AB concatenation, then C concatenation. You can easily implement with another stack the building of the type at the bottom. And I'm going to show how the modify function looks like now. Oh, sorry. Okay. No. Sorry. The modify function looks like this. If there is action char, which is just pushing something on the input, takes current term or previous one, rest of the output stack, and it returns new output stack with char on the top. If it's action sequence, it takes sequence, two arguments on the top of, that's the concatenation, two arguments on the top of the stack, and return concatenation of two action in different order, because on stack they are in different order. If I'm concatenating sequence of something and concatenation, I take the something and concatenation and wrap them together. If it's alternation, I will take two symbols and do the same as concatenation. Again, with multiple options. And with optional, I just wrap it into optional type, which means it's just optional. If it's plus, I take one item and wrap it into plus. If it's star, I do the same. So at the end, for the input ABC, I have concatenation of char A, B, C. And you can copy this and try it around and it will work. Yeah. Okay, how do we match a regular expression in the form of an AST? Before we started, we need to talk about finite automatons. Finite automaton, yeah, read this. Okay, finite automaton is five tuple. Finite set of states, finite set of the input symbols, the alphabet, transition function from the states and alphabet into set of states or state, depending if we are talking about non-deterministic or deterministic finite automaton, and start state, which is part of the state set. And also set of accept or final states. Yeah. And finite automaton accepts exactly the same class of the languages as the regular expressions. So we need to map them. For example, we have integral numbers as a finite automaton. The node is state, the nodes are state, and the links are transitions. So in this case, At the beginning, we are in start state. If we are in set one, we are in another state, which is accepting. So default automaton is accepting. And that is a cycle, so we can input more. But if I want a negative number, I cannot because there is no minus at the beginning. So we need to add a special transition here, so we can accept minus, but not only minus, we need to add a number. Same thing if we want decimal numbers, we need to add more states, more transitions. And if we want scientific number, we need to do the same. Oh, sorry. Okay, how do we convert the irregular expression into a finite automaton? We look on finite automaton. This is finite automaton without any accepting state. This automaton doesn't accept anything, which is like a regular expression, which doesn't take anything. This automaton takes only empty state, only empty input, nothing else. So accepting, but if I provide some input, it doesn't. There is no transition for this state, so it doesn't accept. This one automaton accept only one char. And this automaton accept one char or empty input. This automaton is same. It accepts empty input or one char. But the difference is there is a epsilon transition between nodes. And you can, when you enter the epsilon, when you enter state with epsilon transition, you automatically enter all the other states which are connected with epsilon link. Okay, we have two automaton, A and B, and we want to concatenate them. We connect the final states of the left one with the start state of the right one with epsilon transition. Oh, sorry, alternate, sorry. We need to alternate them in this case. So we introduce new states, start state, and connect it with epsilon link to start state of previous. We are in both, accepting A or B. Okay, now concatenation. We need to connect the final states with the start state, like this. So when input is A, we are suddenly in two states, but we are not accepting yet. We need to provide B. Nothing else, no more B, no. So we have concatenation. If we want to do repetition of AB star, we need to connect the end state with start state, and we create new start state for this repetition. So we have automaton which takes AB, AB, AB star, like empty input is accepted, AB, 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 and so on. But we have epsilon transitions, and we want to remove them. It's not perfectly correct if I tell you, you can just remove them. Just join these states together. It's not working every time, I will show you later. But this automaton is exactly the same. AB, AB. Okay. So that is a direct mapping between regular expression definition and operations over the finite automatons. And we need to map it into C++. So we have the five tuple. Finite set of states will be set of numbers, because now state is just number. Alphabet is char32. Because we are in Unicode world, and we like emoji. Transition is a set of tuples from state, previous state, next state, symbol. Start state is always zero. And final states are another set of states. Okay, we don't need the set of the states, because they are implicitly there with the transition function. Because it's there in the tuple from to and so. We need to implement set in constexpr, because there is no set for now. We have like iterators, we have size, we have access operators, we have insert, we have arrays, and we have constexpr constructor. But there is a problem. We cannot allocate. We need to have fixed set for it. Which is okay, because we can pre-calculate the size of the needed set. So we don't need to any allocation. Okay, transition looks like this. It's structure, source, target, term. There is some constructor which provides some abstraction. And function match, which decide if the current symbol on the input is accepted by the transition. And finite automaton is a template with size of the transition set and size of the final state set. And we have them here. And few constructor and blah, blah, blah. Nothing interesting. And we need to map the basic building blocks into it. So empty finite automaton, which doesn't accept anything, is just finite automaton without no transition, no final state. Epsilon automaton is final automaton, which have one accepting state, which is zero, the start state. And one char automaton is one transition, one accepting state, which is transition from 0 to 1 for the char C, and the state 1 is accepting. Okay, concatenation algorithm. Now, correctly, we have two automatons. One is taking ABC or AAABC, multiple C, and other which takes XXYZ. And we need to concatenate them. So first thing, we calculate prefix of the left one. We have state 0, 1, 2. So first free state is 3. So we added 3 to all states on the right, 3, 4, 5. Now we remove the final states from the left and start state from the right. And we connect them with epsilon node. Now, maybe you can see why I cannot just merge the nodes 2 and 3. Because it will allow me to interleave C and X, C, C, X, C, X, C, X. So I need to do something else. For epsilon state, I can show it to A, B, C, 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 X, epsilon Z. The epsilon transition can be replaced with all transition from the target state, which is going to change their source to source state, like this. I copy all the transition from state 3 to state 2. And I have automaton without epsilon state. And it's exactly the same. Okay, concatenation algorithm as a constexpr with finite automatons as a template argument. We have left one, right one, and we have function calculate, which precalculate the size of all transition from the left and the right. Calculate transition which going from the right start state. Calculate the prefix. Create output type based on the needed size of all transitions needed and final states from the right. I copy all transition from the left to output, and I connect all the left final states with right start state. So I will take all transition from it, doesn't matter. And I copy them into the output. So I add a prefix from the target to the target, and I take same source from the left. Okay. And then I copy all transition from the right with the prefix. And then I copy all the final states from the right with the prefix to the output. And I'm done. I calculated the output of the concatenation of two automatons for the value of automatons, not for the type. Because at the beginning, it's not type, it's a value. Okay, and I have shorthand for the concatenation, which is static inline constexpr variable, like this concatenation of two algorithms, left to right. I'm done. Okay, there are other algorithms like alternation, which works exactly the same. You just do alternation, not concatenation. Repetition is just the same as I described with the example. They work same. You need to precalculate the size because you cannot allocate yet, and then you populate the content. So at the end, it looks like this. You have concatenation, one char, and you have final automaton at the end. I call it compile time functions with compile time arguments. And unlike constexpr functions, these are truly constexpr arguments. And also it makes sure that some compilers do the caching. Because in this case, the caching is helpful. Okay, but when you do the alternation, concatenation, your automaton can easily be non-deterministic. You have more transition for same char from same node, from same state to multiple states. So you need to do determinization. But it can generate you 2^n new states, which can explode. It looks like this. I'm in start state, and if I provide A, I'm going to two states, 0 and 1. Suddenly, I'm in two states. And if I provide B, I'm in two states again. So I need to determinize state 0 and 1 by merging them into new state, 0, 1 state. Now, for input A, I'm only in one state. But for input B, I'm still in two. So I need to merge 1 and 2. Now I have a deterministic automaton, which is exactly the same as the previous one, but I'm always only in one state. No, sorry. Okay, it can generate 2^n new states, and you cannot do it at once. Because if you do it at once, you need to allocate 2^n new states. And if you have automaton with 60 states, you are screwed. So you need to do it iteratively. You need to check if your automaton is deterministic. If not, you need to do determinization and again, which means I'm going to build new automaton, try it, copy it, create new one, a new one, which means a lot of calculation and copying because there is no reference semantics in ConstExpr. You cannot do allocation, so you have only values. You need to copy all the transitions, everything. It's also, after that, you can minimize the automaton usually to smaller one. Okay, we have deterministic automaton. But there is a ConstExpr problem. The ConstExpr problem. Determinizing of arbitrary long automaton takes 6 seconds on GCC. Not nice. With Clang, it's quite better, and it's going to be much better when JF and his friends will end with the ConstExpr interpreter. But 6 4 seconds. But you can do better. PHP takes only half second. So there are interpreter languages like PHP, which is much quicker than ConstExpr in C++. ConstExpr in C++ is interpreted language, not compiled one. Because abstraction is good, but also bad. Another ConstExpr problems. Every operation counts. Every call, every expression counts because compiler must parse it, do it something with it, and move on. There is a limit. There are limits in compilers, and they are different in each compiler, which makes fun to implement this. Also, there is no move semantics. You need to do copy of everything. Also, you don't have error handling, and you cannot easily debug. My favorite method of debugging is meditating. You can use conditional undefined behavior or throw statements as a form of assert. There is also a variant of print for debugging. You try to instantiate this template, and it gives you the type you're trying to instantiate, which helps. Okay. And we need to match the regular expression in form of a final automaton we built. So there is a function CTRE match and search. For the DFA variant is fast match fast search. Okay, fast match function takes the range, some input. It can be string, it can be vector of bool, whatever. First. There is a static assert which check if the pattern is correct. Then I extract the type from the pattern, and then I take the AST of the pattern, create non-deterministic automaton, determinize it, minimize it, and then call function match state with DFA and two iterators of my input. Okay, we need to build the finite automaton from the AST. So we have function build, which take a list of the AST, which is another stack, and empty automaton, which doesn't accept anything at the beginning. And there is a function build I'm going to show you. Build function takes the stack and seed of the automaton. At the beginning is empty, and I return the seed if the stack is empty. If on stack there is an epsilon symbol from the AST, I just take the automaton on the left, concatenate it with the epsilon, and remove it from the stack and call build function again recursively. Okay. Then, if there is a char on the stack, on the AST stack, I will take the char and concatenate it with the left automaton and build new automaton and remove it from the stack and call again recursively build. Concatenation sequence is same. I will take concatenation sequence, unwrap it, and call build again. Alternation is a little different. I will take multiple of options, build automaton for each of it, and then build alternation of the automatons, and then concatenate it with the left one. And recursively call build again. Start repetition is same. I will build the inner automaton and then wrap it into star and concatenate it with the left one. Okay, we have finite automaton from the AST, and now we need to do new matching. The next match wrapper is function fast match, which takes the NFA, determinize it, minimize it, and then call function match state with the automaton and the two iterators. Match state takes the automaton, current state, defaultly zero because we are in start state, and pair of iterators. If current state is final and I'm at the end of the input, I'm returning true. If not, I'm returning false. Otherwise, I look for the first transition in the set because they are ordered by the source state. Look for the index and call function choose transition with the DFA index and current state. And it's everything is tail recursion because this is run also in runtime. Okay, so choose transition takes the automaton, index of current transition, current state, again pair of iterators. If I'm out of boundaries of the transition set, or I'm on different state than I supposed to be, I return false, because there is no transition for me. If current transition at current index match my input, I call function match state with new state because the transition give me new state recursively. Again, tail recursion. If not, I call transition for next index. I will try all transition from for current state. And at the end, if I run into different state or out of the boundaries, I return false. The time for matching is n times t, where t is average number of transition per state, and you don't need any dynamic memory because it doesn't allocate anything and everything is tail recursion. At the end, it will be just jumping in assembly. But it doesn't support capture tracking because no one found a solution for this algorithm yet. And it's theoretically the quickest approach for matching or searching. It allows you to use stream data if you transform this into coroutines somehow. You can fork on stream data and you don't need to remember anything. Okay, there are different other algorithms to matching. NFA backtracking, NFA bit-all backtracking. NFA backtracking algorithm is used in CTRE for default engine, as a default engine. You can do captures, you can do back references, but it can explode in complexity. And I'm working on NFA bit-all backtracking, which allows to have captures, but it's still pretty quick. Yeah. Let's read some assembly. Standard regular expression, aloha or A to Z star. Function match, which takes string view and tries to match it. And it generates nicely 13,000 lines of assembly. Full implementation of stat regex is included for you. Okay. Boost regex. Same. Need to compile a little bit. And it takes only 6,000 lines of assembly. Better. Okay, and we are going with CTRE. Fast match. It's 17 lines. And interesting thing, you cannot see the aloha in assembly because aloha is subset of A to Z star. And there is no call, there are only jumps. Okay, benchmarks. For this scenario, I use my laptop because I can. I have big files of 6.5 millions of lines of CSV-like data. I did median of three measurements. And I use GCC 9.1 and Clang 8 with 2A mode and O3. Okay, standard regular expression with comparison with EGREP. So you can see that EGREP is bigger than something we have in C++. JavaScript core and node as JF showed me how to do it. Like pointed at it, I should do it, so I did it. They are much quicker. JavaScript is quicker than C++. Okay. If we look on libraries usually used, Expressive, Boost, PCRE, RE2 from Google, we can see they are much better. RE2 is awesome, by the way. PCRE with jitting is 2 gigabytes per second. But you cannot use it in all environments because you need to allow to generate assembly on fly, which is not secure, especially in PCRE with so many insecure holes. Okay, I removed the JavaScript and grep. CTRE with backtracking is 600 megabytes for this pattern per second, and CTRE with DFA is 2 gigabytes. And it's static. It's compiled by your compiler with Clang. With GCC, even backtracking is somehow optimized, so it's quick. Because depends on pattern, obviously. If we change the pattern to more backtracking heavy, the CTRE is slower, but PCRE somehow, everything is going lower because in searching there are so many states, so the assembly is much bigger and it's slower, but for all engines, if you look. Same compiler, but differences. Only ABC at the end of pattern and you are on quarter of the performance. Okay, with Clang, there is a little difference. CTRE is slower at Clang, somehow with backtracking, but the CTRE with DFA is still pretty quick. Okay, the code I measured is look like this. I include all the libraries I'm using. I prepare the pattern. I load file by lines into a big buffer, and I get there's some prep warm up, and I measure only hot section, and I iterating the lines I load from the buffer, and I do searching, not matching, searching. So I'm looking for anything inside it, and I counting the lines so I can check the output between engines. And at the end, I'm going to print the result. So compilation with Clang. Baseline is compilation without any matching. I just include the headers, and I don't do any preparation of the expression, and don't do any matching. So 3 seconds takes only to parse the all header files. Standard expression, 5 seconds, when I start using it. CTRE, DFA, and CTRE, non-DFA. The non-DFA version is pretty quick to compile because it's usually linear with the input. But DFA is doing determinization, minimization, a lot of stuff. If you use PCRE, RE2, they are just calling some external function, so it's quick. Also, we can look, we can remove the baseline. Oh, yeah, expressive boost. We can remove the baseline and look on the cost of the compilation itself. It's not nice for CTRE DFA, but the performance. You need to choose if you want big performance or not. But CTRE with back references, backtracking is quick to compile anyway. And I'm working on new parser, which should be much quicker, and some new algorithms there. With GCC, it's even worse. And I hope JF will make Clang better. But you are responsible. Okay, future of CTRE library. There will be better context per parser, not type-based, but I will still be able to generate same assembly. I almost finished it in time, but no, I didn't. NFA matching with captures, so it will be linear with the input. And if you want a runtime regular expression, go to Hal's talk on Friday. We will have runtime compile time regular expressions. And 5 things I showed you: how regular expression engines work, connection between theory and code, parsing of the pattern and during compilation, how it's done, building finite automaton, and comparison between different engines. And you should remember 4 things. Compiler can optimize your code if you help them. JF, you should do better. combining template metaprogramming and context per code can you help express things clearly. You are no longer tied by types, but that is a cost in abstraction, as Chandler said. And you should stop pretending context per C++ is a compiled language. It's not. You don't need types there, almost. And try CTRE library in your code. It can help you with speed, but also with code clarity, because you have pattern as part of your code. And you, if there is a typo in your pattern, it gives you compile time error. Thank you. Any question?
Do you have any preparation against compile time explosion of DFA?
Sorry?
You know, like if you provide something more complicated pattern, your compile time can grow like, significantly. Do you have any protection against that?
I cannot hear because the echo. Sorry. No, there is no protection because I cannot stop I cannot measure compile time speed in during compilation. So
do you have an algorithm? I mean, like, for example,
try it without my mic and I will repeat it. I'm not doing any optimization and I'm not doing any like security checking for such input. It will generate crazy amount of assembly because it's bounded. So I need to like I don't have counted transitions or states. So you can do it and it will probably become old until it's compiled. Without mic, please. Okay.
So you're using variables to represent lists of things. Mm. Have you compared that with versus a linked list type structure? Because there's kind of a trade-off with variables. You essentially are using arrays.
I will try to repeat the question. I try to use different thing than type list, I cannot create a linked list in with types. I have only a type list, which is only tool I can have, or values. But for the values. Okay. Follow-up question was if I try to use type and rest and like matryoshka, and it's actually the same. You need to instantiate new type and every time, so it doesn't matter.
Right. One thing that I've run into is if you say you have a thousand elements, if you're working with that, you end up with one that's a thousand.
But still the type as a whole must be instantiated with everything in it, and it's new type from the perspective of compiler. Jeff? Yeah. Obviously.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Another question. Question is if I have some techniques to optimize the compilation time for backtracking, I do. There is some called trampolining, which helps. But for this, not yet. I'm working on better approach, which will be much quicker. But it's like proof of concept, but it's already really quick. Like not compilation, but the performance, which is something that matter for me. Okay. Eric.
This is pretty exciting. Do you have plans to bring it to the committee?
I do. I do have plans to bring it to committee. Okay, thank you.